this point.
Yep. Wouldn't that be such a bummer if he just never does? And the writer's like, I don't know why everyone thinks Gendry's coming back.
Yeah.
But what would you do with, like...
Yeah.
Yeah, why was he even important? I think he was important. I mean, he could be seen as important because of, like, Melisandre's use for him while he was with Stannis' army. But, yeah, that feels like such an easy, cold, like, open. He's just out in the ether somewhere.
All right. So, guys, overall, good episode. I think we all agree. So, I want to get into our game of the week. I do have a game plan for you guys. So, here we go. In our last section here, we'd like to play a sort of a thinking man's game in the world of Westeros. And again, if you have an idea for a game for us to play, you can reach out to us. Shameless plug, geeks, that's G-E-E-K-S at H-O-T-Y-B.co. But this game, guys, I want us all to have our own little battle. Well, between you two. This is a game that we play on the Hold On To Your Butts proper show quite often. It's called Scenarios, where I present a scenario to the guys, and they have to give me their responses, and I choose the winner based off of nothing but my own opinion. So it's kind of like Whose Line Is It Anyway, in that sense. The points don't matter. So you can ask me any questions you want after I give you the scenario. We'll leave the question floor open. Make sure to ask all of them, because I will judge you harshly on the ones that you don't ask. And then I will close the question floor, and then you will each give me your guys' response. Well, it's not going to work quite that way. You'll see how this goes. But, yeah, it's probably grab a beer. You guys should probably grab a beer for this.
Working on it.
So, can you grab me one while you're down there, too?
What haven't you drank yet?
I don't know what I haven't drank.
Also, shout out. So I bought this beer, and remember, I am a beer geek. So we are drinking High Wire, which is from Asheville, North Carolina.
Very tasty.
Very tasty. You had this one yet?
I did have the low pitch. Yep. This is exciting for our listeners. While you figure that out, I'm going to go. No, give the low pitch.
I've had the low pitch. Do you have a low pitch?
I'm good. Yeah, I got. Oh no, but I'll drink.
Okay, so that one's yours.
It's a good one. All right. So while we're figuring out the beer situation, here is this week's scenario. I'm gonna have you two battle it out.
Or not?
I did have it.
Okay, so that one's mine.
This is very confusing.
That one's mine.
And then inevitably, whatever we got here.
So high pitch.
I'm not at high pitch.
There
we go. We
gotta
figure it out.
All right. Disaster averted.
All right. So we don't do a lot of editing on this podcast. You're gonna tell right away off of that. Tonight's scenario is going to be: you two are going to war. You two are now you're sitting on the respective thrones. I'm not going to say where because I haven't thought of that. But you're sitting on your respective thrones, and you get to put three armies together from the world of Westeros. You get to put three armies together from the world of Westeros, and who do you choose and why? Now, we're going to do this like playground sports style. So I've randomly selected. I have done this earlier. John is going to go first. He gets first pick, okay? And John picks a army from the world of Westeros, then Joe picks an army, and so forth. Okay? And I will decide who wins and why. Now, the question floor is now open. You can ask me anything you want about the war and who you're picking, who you can pick, stuff like that. So,
is this historical, like, throughout the entire Game of Thrones?
From what we've seen, yeah. From the show run, not, like, from history. So you can't choose, like, Aegon and his giant dragon and stuff
yeah.
like that.
Well, we've seen Aegon and his giant dragons, too.
True.
But also, so my question is, geography-wise, where is, obviously we're going to war, but where is the climax? Like, obviously.
But where's the battle
Where's
happening?
The big battle happening?
The big battle's it's at King's Landing.
Okay.
Yep, happening at King's Landing.
Okay, and then the other question is, Dany's army, what does that look like? Does she have Unsullied? Does she have Dothraki?
She does not. So her whole army is broken up. Like, so you're Dany in that sense.
Individual units, right?
Yeah. Just like Daenerys has put together an army, you're putting together an army. Just like Cersei is starting to make alliances, you're putting together alliances and stuff too. So don't think about the main players. Think about who they've been recruiting are your options.
Gotcha.
So any force described in the TV show, correct? Any force. Okay.
Described and I want to say currently engaged. Like, not currently engaged, but have been engaged throughout the, like, run of the TV show. So you have to have seen them in battle,
yes.
or they're preparing for battle.
Got it.
Got a TV show.
And I get to go first?
You do.
I'm going to win.
Who do you got? I bet I know.
The Night King's army.
Oh. Yeah, that's pretty good.
That's a...
Fuck. Okay, I'm going to not allow the Night King. I'm sorry. I'm going to not allow it.
Or
that
was like... That's the Helen Keller card, right?
Question 4 still being open. I'm going to not allow the White Walkers and the Night King's army.
Lame.
I'm sorry. You're right, though. That would have been an easy win.
Can I just get Jon Snow times 10,000?
Yeah, no, no multiplications.
Yeah, fair.
Any more questions
before
we get into the
It's established forces, but not, like, necessarily historically concurrent. So, like... Anybody who has ever been a player in the Game of Thrones.
Yes. Yes.
Minus the
White Walkers.
Yep.
Lame.
Question floor is now closed. John, you're up first. Who is your number one overall draft pick?
My first pick will, without a doubt, be the Unsullied.
Oh, that's it. I did not see that coming. Okay. Why the Unsullied?
Well, they are trained from pretty much birth for war. And they have no dicks, so they are not thinking about anything else other than...
I think Grey Worm told us that's not true.
Well,
I think he did.
He's kind of afraid of boobs, I guess. The Unsullied, because, I mean, pretty much from a very early age, they are trained to fight, and they use spears and shields and can lock in tight formation, which we've not seen in the show yet, but, like, that's what they're trained to do.
Yeah. I'll take Euron, because he's a badass after this last episode, and the Iron Fleet.
Ooh, nice. Okay, Euron and the Iron Fleet.
I'll explain all three when we get there, once I know.
Okay, that's fair. Okay, John, you can follow the same strategy.
Oh,
I've already explained
my choices.
You got
one of my choices.
So number three overall draft pick.
I've only had one, though, so far.
Well, you were one, he was two, you're three.
Oh.
We're doing NFL-style drafts.
Oh, I'm also going to pick the Knights of the Vale. So they kind of... Oh, wait, we're not explaining until the end, right?
You can or can't.
Well, I will now. So the Knights of the Vale are... So they're untouched as far as we know, but it's also, like, just heavy armored cavalry charging down very little, other than the Unsullied. As far as we know, can stop them.
Now, I'm also going to say that grants you Littlefinger. So, there you go.
Yeah, sure, I'll take him. Stab him in the dick.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
What little we know about them, I'm going to take the Tarly army. Randall Tarly's army.
I'm really surprised at a omission so far from both of you. But, okay, the Tarly's.
Not omitted yet.
Yeah. The Tarly's, okay. And John?
Dothraki.
Okay, there it is. I was like, what? Okay.
Yeah, I knew it was coming.
Wow. Okay, so you've got...
But I have an ace in the hole.
Okay, all right. So you've got... your whole team now is the Unsullied, the Knights of the Vale, and the Dothraki.
None of them fight at sea. All right, go ahead.
Well, it's going to be like Aquaman. It's going to be like, hey, come in the water. You want
to
come in?
Come in. I don't need to fight at sea. I can control all of the land territory.
Okay.
There's always so many fish in the sea.
Joe, your third and final pick.
So my third is very interesting because we really haven't seen them much. But all we hear about is how fucking powerful they are. The Lannister army. The Lannister army feels massive. It feels like a complete contingent. They also have, and I know this doesn't play into it, but they have...
Ed Sheeran.
They have Ed Sheeran, and he can sing for days. But they also have a ton of money involved, and they're also sitting, well, and I mean it might vary, but they're sitting at King's Landing, right? So all of that combined, I feel like they're a well-rounded army. From what we've heard, it hasn't been much, but they feel like a really powerful force that hasn't really been showcased yet.
And they've also got Casterly Rock, which has never been sacked, apparently, right?
Right.
And we might not only tell
next
week.
However, I control, with my army, all of the land. Sure, you have Euron Greyjoy.
Let the debate begin.
Fleet,
you guys debate this.
But I have all of the physical land in Westeros. I can cover it all with the Dothraki Horde. I can cover it all with Knights of the Vale. The Unsullied will hold wherever my main fortress is. You have no grain. You have salt water.
Salt water is good. Hard to argue with that debate.
I can control all of the fresh
water. I was
going to
let him stop, but yeah, yep. Whatever. Yeah, so the Lannister army is obviously on land. They have, from what it seems, they have plenty of soldiers. They have strong armor, etc. Feels like a very similar army to the Knights of the Vale, but bigger. I would also say that the Iron Fleet, right, is equipped to push on the land from the sea because of whatever fireball action Euron had going on, and that dude is fucking crazy. So there's no mercy for them. They feel like a Dothraki army at the sea. And then the Tarly army is the in-between, right? They're the archers. They're the arrow people. They're going to just spray all sorts of harm on the Dothraki or whomever is charging at our forces. So that's how I felt, and that's how I thought about it from there.
My guys win because they have no dicks.
I think it goes the other way. Anyways, I think if we're trying to, like, think about it from, like, a defensive perspective, it would be very smart to, like, just batten down the hatches and say, yeah, I'm going to defend the land for all eternity, right? But if I'm going to have to take over Westeros, I feel like you need to have land, or you need to have land army, you need to have a sea army, because you can get around those castles, especially on the water, and then the Tarly army would be an opportunity to have airstrikes.
All right. Now, in classic Game of Thrones style, each of you get to steal an army from the other person.
Oh,
who is it?
Well, then, obviously, I'm going to take the Iron Fleet.
And, okay, you're taking the Iron Fleet. Joe, who are you taking from him?
I feel like the Dothraki are just ruthless, and so that's like an even swap, and that kind of fits the gap within my army. That's all what right. I was looking to do.
So now the teams are, Joe, you have?
Tarly's, Dothraki, and the Lannisters.
And John, you have?
The Iron Fleet, the Unsullied, and the Knights of the Vale.
Dude, can we just talk about how stupid spears are?
So I still beat the dog.
It's true.
I mean, they're good with them, but
yeah.
Damn. I mean, like, a sword is much more accurate.
It's just heavy and, like, real, like, they're just, like, yeah.
Imagine fighting in a hallway with a spear.
Hey.
They call it a joust.
All right, guys, I've made my decision. The winner of the first ever army duel on the Westeros Gazette podcast. It's sticking. I like it.
I like it a lot.
Yeah. John wins. John has won. It was a close battle, but I gotta say, him taking the Iron Fleet with the Knights of the Vale, who I look at as the ground cover. Now, I know the Dothraki are a phenomenal ground cover, but he also now has the sea cover, and he also has just, I'm gonna look at the Unsullied as the utility knife. They can pretty much do whatever, wherever, and
with their spears.
With their spears.
Without their dicks.
They're overcompensating. I think it'll be really interesting to see, though, because essentially we're talking about the battle that might happen in the next episode. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Pretty
down
much.
The line, the Tarlys and the
Dothraki.
Right?
Yeah.
So, cool. It's been teased.
Guys, thank you so much for tuning in and listening to our Game of Thrones Episode 2, Season 7 spoiler cast. We appreciate it. Remember to subscribe to the Hold On To Your Butts podcast. You'll get this great show, as well as our regular proper show, which happens each week. I'm going to burp again. Goddamn those beers.
Yeah, that's really good stuff.
And so you'll get each and every episode delivered to your podcast listening app of choice, whether that be Stitcher, iTunes, SoundCloud, YouTube, however you listen to your podcast, make sure to subscribe. And it would do us a great honor if you would take the time to leave us a review, good or bad. It helps us either way. We really appreciate it. And share it with your friends, if they're fans of the show. We'd love to get their opinions and earn their listenership for each week. We've got one more, two, six, five more of these episodes to go.
So at least,
yeah, absolutely. We're talking about how we continue this show beyond that. We'd love your suggestions too. Feel free to reach out to us again, geeks@hotyb.co. We appreciate you guys. Thank you so much for listening. And John, it's your turn for an outro sound this week. Is there a White Walker?
Sure, let's go with that.
All right.